better with that.
I do too. And these come with a 90-day warranty rather than the other had a 30-day warranty.
Four or five years, they'll be back anyway.
But if we get them through the general and we see that there's issues with them, we can at least replace them. But I couldn't find anywhere that they had over a year warranty, even new ones. So warranties really weren't an issue, but it did make me feel more comfortable about replacements if any of them were just came out of the box bad. They should be in this week. One of Scott's primary duties, which he's going to be up there with Anita over the next week until we get these computers in, he's doing voter registration and trying to get, I think Anita told me today, we're averaging about 50 absentee ballots being sent out a day.
That many percentage?
Yeah, absentees are hopping. We've already got them back in. We're getting, I know I'm getting 10 to 15 requests online every day because I forward those to Anita. So he's really helping up front. But his primary duty over the next few weeks is going to be getting the software on these laptops and getting those ready to go. And then also he's going to help test the machines and the equipment. So we're real excited about having him here and having some muscle and brawn. And he's also going to be going out with Carl, who's usually who we use to deliver the equipment. I think I'm going to send Scott so Anita can stay in that last few days.
Scott listening to all the precincts are?
Yes. Carl's there. Scott's there. He knows where it is.
We have an election day.
Yes. It sure will. So another reason we're excited to have him in here. We will be hiring. We're actually talking to some of our regulars about getting them in for one-stop hours and so forth. So all of it's coming together. We kind of wait until October because we've planned it out earlier than that, and it never ends up being the way we plan it. So we're really putting our feet to the fire this week and next week and getting that stuff done. So the poll workers are in. What I would like to know, I would really like to get the party chairman in here. I don't know if y'all want to do a lunch meeting or just any meeting, really. Get them both in here. Show them what we've got as far as the new folks that the newspaper article about poll workers has brought up. We've got a lot of younger retirees that have a lot of computer experience. So I'm thinking we're getting some really good folks in that wouldn't normally know about the process. And both Surrey and Charles have both said that they were very excited about us doing that because we're not taking that out of the chairman's duties. What we're doing is just gathering the information, giving it to them, and then they'll turn around and say, we approve this, that, and the other. So
it doesn't let you have sufficient coverage this year?
Yeah, I think we're going to be fine. We have talked to several high schools about the student election assistance, and you know everybody loves student election assistance. Poll workers do because they've got a whole lot of
energetic
and excited, and it just where they're like, oh god, presidential election. They're like, oh, let's go. They're enthusiastic. That's a very good word.
We're up making mistakes.
So would you? Is there any days that you don't think would be good? I'd want to do it probably early next week sometime, Monday or Tuesday.
Come here with me next Monday? Next Tuesday?
Not next Tuesday, but the following Tuesday we start with our absentee.
No problem.
Next week's our last week off.
Yep.
Or sometime.
And you know, I don't know. I could probably meet them individually and then get that back to y'all. It's up to y'all. I think it would be a good thing to bring them both in and we just sit down and say, look.
I'm fine all day too.
Okay, so Tuesday would be an okay day. That would seem.
What's wrong with it?
And just.
What time?
Lay it out. Let me talk to them and see what time would
Anytime
be good.
Anytime Tuesday's fine with me. The 9th, right?
Yes, the 9th.
That way we'll be there for Tuesday this morning.
I'm sorry. I'm going to be at Northeast tonight. I was thinking that. I'm sorry. I was thinking it was the 10th. Can we do it Monday or Wednesday?
I got a 1:30 meeting on Monday.
Would Wednesday be good?
I guess so. Go to the doctor's office at 10 o'clock. It won't take long.
So So, let's see. We can try for this Friday if you want to.
I'm fine on Friday.
Anything on your schedule for Friday?
Nope.
Okay, good.
So I'll talk
to Suri and Charles today, but I think we all need to kind of get on board and say, look, we got a lot going on the next few weeks. You know, I want them to be very comfortable with our office, and if they see anything going on that we need to know about. I was on the phone this week. We're getting an awful lot of calls from the political campaigns, Romney and Obama's both, and they've been in here. In fact, I thought I do need to ask y'all about that. I forgot. Have been on the phone, and I hate to say it this way, but they're gearing up for, I hate to say lawsuits, but they're gearing up for possible problems that could come with the elections. And the Romney campaign, I stayed on the phone with at least an hour last week explaining to them the security measures we take when the machines are out, when they're tested. They wanted to know fine details, like when the PCI-CA cards are unsealed and how that's delivered to the state. I mean, they were very technical on wanting to know if we have sheriff's deputies accompany the ballots to and from the polls. And I was like, no, we don't. But we, and explained to him the security issues that we have. And I happened to be one of the first counties he called. I guess it's because it's Beaufort County. They start at the top. So his general knowledge of the M100s and stuff was not as up to date as it needed to be. I have given the attorneys for the Romney campaign in North Carolina my personal cell phone number and told them to look, if anything's going on in Beaufort County that y'all are feeling uncomfortable about, then call me. Call me immediately. This is, you know, don't give out the phone number to everybody, but y'all are more than welcome to it. And I've done that with most of the bigger campaigns that, you know, are going to be working on Election Day. Because, for instance, what was going on when we had the new election in 2002, I had no idea that was going on all day. So if something's going on that seems suspicious, then you need to alert us to it and we can stop the bleeding before it gets too bad. So, and that's what I want to make both of the parties, that we're a team. All of us are a team. We just need to get through this election, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of things. We're getting a lot of people that are misinformed about a lot of information with voting this particular election. They're coming in. We've seen a lot of emails being forwarded to us about military voting. Apparently there's been some issue about military voting down, and they think we're disenfranchising them. So there's a lot of that going on right now. So my main concern is we want integrity, and we want to be as transparent as we can to anybody. And I've made no promises for a perfect election. I said, when there's this many people involved, we just can't do it. But if something's going on that we don't know about, please make us aware of it so that we can deal with it properly. So that's been going on a lot in the last couple weeks. The website's booming. We're getting a whole lot of hits on it. Let me jump back to this. I got hit in the parking lot in my car. I wasn't sitting at my desk. We were asked, or the office was asked, and it might be that y'all will want to wait for an official request. But I can't remember what organization that this fella is with. He comes in weekly to check with us. I want to say it's Organizing America, I believe. Wanted to know if Beaufort County was sending teams to nursing homes. And under North Carolina General Statute, we can, it is optional, send bipartisan teams to nursing homes to make sure that they're at least made aware of the opportunities they have to vote. Now, it's not required for y'all to do it. There's specific laws about who can and cannot go into nursing homes. The employees and so forth can't help residents at nursing